Hello, my name is T.I.G.E.R. Santosh Nair, and once again I'm back with the Business Solution Capsule. I had promised you that every Friday I will come up with a Business Solution Capsule, BSC, Business Solution Capsule. And here I am again. And today the topic that I'm going to talk about is how to pay salaries in difficult times. One of the biggest challenges that you and I are facing as small and medium entrepreneurs and also big entrepreneurs is the inability to pay salaries on time because business has gone for a toss because of the various challenges and uncertainties that have happened, including COVID on one side. Now, the only way is to have a clear view that we must pay salaries on time as much as possible. But that is very easily said than done. In difficult times, what I would suggest is, number one, you know, if you can withdraw from your command funds. Now, command funds, I have always taught in my class in Gurukul programs, is that we should create a command funds. A command fund is like different kinds of funds that we create so that we can use in different times. For example, a crisis fund is created with a small amount and then you keep on adding to that amount and create a big amount, and it's known as a crisis fund. So any crisis that the company goes through, either it's a market crisis or it's an environment crisis or it's a COVID crisis, you are in a position to take care of all these, you know, in a very big way. So different, you know, crisis fund, sudden opportunity fund, you know, an opportunity comes, you can use that particular fund. A walk away fund, you know, is another fund where you walk out of situations that you don't like because you have enough amount of money. And then you have technology fund, you know, whenever a new technology is coming, you're using that fund. You have education fund or a cash development, K-A-S-H-S, you know, knowledge, attitude, skills, habits, strategies, and creativity in order to upgrade your education or knowledge, you know, and that's the kind of a fund. So the first thing is that you must start creating a command funds in the days to come. If you don't already have a command fund, I used to have a lot of command funds which all got exhausted during the, you know, COVID period. So you must have a command fund. If you have it, use the money. If you don't have it, create it. This way you will be in a position to pay salaries on time. One of the most important things is employees who come to work with you, they come for four reasons, you know. They come for four reasons. They want safety, they want security, they want guarantee, they want predictability. And because of these four things, you know, they are either entitled to get their salary, which is no doubt their right also. But when companies go through difficult times, they should use their command funds. That's number one. Number two is that call a meeting of all the people and explain the situation to them and tell them that we will make part payments to them and that we will pay 30% or 40% or 50%, depending upon whatever is your capacity. And the rest we will pay as the situation eases up and make a commitment to that effect. But it is very important that you call a meeting and communicate. Most of the small and medium entrepreneurs, you know, do not communicate. They say, you know, we are not in a position to pay now. What is there to speak? You know, they will understand. No, don't leave it to their understanding, because they can understand it in a wrong manner. They can understand it in a difficult manner. They can understand in a manner that is not desirable. That will lead to gossip, and that will lead to, you know, people politicking the situation. You know, I don't think so, we are going to get paid. And so a panic situation can get created. And in order that you avoid the panic, the politics, the rumors and gossip and all those things, it is important that you call a meeting and do the communication. The third is to call a meeting and explain your situation that we are unable to pay the salary. What do you think should be done? And they can come up with very exciting, wonderful solutions. And that is something that if you feel is feasible, 1, 2, 3, 4, and take it with an open heart and open mind and look at the possibilities of their suggestions being implemented. The next is, you know, providing them incentives, saying that, you know, you can convert this whole thing into an incentive. I told all the people in my company when COVID started about 1.5 years ago, I said, all of you sell, right from the receptionist to the office boy, to the driver, to the personal assistant, executive assistant, to people in reviews, trainers, salespeople, everybody. I said, you know, Tom Peters said that business development and selling is everybody's responsibility. So I said, all of you can sell and I'm going to give you incentive. Now, these are not normal incentives. these were incentives. Like I remember in Santosh Nair Knowledge Products and Merchandise, we went up to, if they sold something of 10,000, they would get an incentive, $5,000. You know, I said, in any case, they were not going to sell. You know, these are people who were not supposed to sell. So when they sold, they were given 50% of the value of that particular thing. So you can give them 30%, 40%, 50% incentives. Tell everybody to get that thing done. You know, the other thing is, I also told them to take up projects. Like I told my accountants, why don't you take an accounting project with some company? I told my, you know, my reviewers, why don't you take a review, you know, projects in some other company? I told my heads, why don't you take personal coaching projects? You know, so if you can take these projects in various companies, that could also be a great thing. And they can get paid 25%, 30%, 35% or whatever, depending upon the whole thing. The next thing is to have a conversation and reduce the salary, you know, saying that we will not be in a position to pay 100%. We will reduce it by 50%, but 50% we will make it variable. Now variable will be on achievements, on performance, on revenue, or whatever may be the case. You can do even that kind of thing. The extreme step that you can take when you're committed to make payments, you know, which I have done many times in the past, and I have done this during the COVID period, is to sell off, you know, any important property that you have. Like I sold off my Andheri East property and I paid salaries, you know, to all the people. Then I sold my wife's entire jewelry and I paid it, because I know this jewelry was made when we were making money and this home was bought when we were making money. So over a period of time, you can sell off your property, you can break the fixed deposit. I took all my investments of the future and I broke it, and all my mutual funds and everything, I exhausted everything and made payments. And today I'm rebuilding everything. Today I'm rebuilding the company, rebuilding everything, because the service industry got hit very badly. Training industry got hit very, very badly. And I'm sure that, I don't know which industry you belong to, but you know, these things are quite possible. This is business. Business has got ups and downs, and we are entrepreneurs and we are supposed to take risks. So I sold off, you know, various important properties that I had, you know, and deposits and jewelry and, you know, break your investments, all kinds of borrow money if you feel that you can, with the belief that you're going to build it back. Because if you trust your business, like I have my vision card in front of me, you know, I get out of bed every day in the morning to provide path-breaking solutions. And by 2035, I have to become a billion-dollar company. And therefore, I am very optimistic about the future. And if you are optimistic about the future, if you are optimistic about business, training industry is not going to finish off or die. The forms of training may change, from classroom to online to digital training to virtual training to probably e-learning. It may all change and you will have to change with time. But the fact of the matter is, you need to pay salaries on time. And if you have all these combined, but the fact is, believe in the company, believe in what you're doing, believe in your employees, because at the end of the day, when things improve, these are the guys who are going to help you back build the whole organization if you have them with you. Now, you know, don't be afraid of some people leaving you and going during this particular period because of anxiety. Once they go, you can always call them back. Once they go, they may also realize it doesn't matter, you know, because we can't be guaranteeing everything to everybody and every time, all the time. But we as entrepreneurs have a responsibility to make these payments on time. And I wish you the very best. This is another Business Solution Capsule, and I'm sure you enjoyed being with me, how to pay salaries on time in difficult times also. Keep thinking about more ways of doing it, but remain committed. Remember that an employee is looking for safety, security, guarantee, and predictability. Give him the safety, give him the security, give him the guarantee, and give him the predictability. You owe it to him. He owes himself to you to create the best possibilities and perform well and keep the productivity alive. That's his responsibility, while you take this responsibility. We became entrepreneurs and to take care of people. We became entrepreneurs to provide employment. We became entrepreneurs to provide, you know, to fulfill our dreams through a group of people. Nothing can be achieved in isolation, and you can't do anything in life all alone. So all the very best, and thank you very much. My name is T.I.G.E.R. Santosh Nair. Good luck, and see you soon with another Business Solution Capsule on a Friday. Bye.